This is the new Mercedes-AMG E63. Well, I say new, it's actually just a facelift, but there are quite a few changes, and I'll tell you about them now in the Car Wow Top 10 Things You Need to Know About the New E63. Mercedes has updated the look of both the saloon and the estate versions of the AMG E63. Now, we were given exclusive access to film the estate, so that's what we'll focus on here. But the changes are the same across both body styles. That means you get the same bulging wheel arches, load size skirts and massive air intakes as the old car. But check out the grille. Instead of a horizontal bar behind the Mercedes badge, it gets the same Pana Americana design as the AMG GT 4-door, AMG A45 and the AMG GT. The grille outline also curves down instead of up, so it looks a bit angrier. At the sides, there's 19-inch alloys as standard, but go for an E63S model and you get 20-inch rims. Round the back, the car gets the same new brake lights as a normal facelifted E-Class estate, so they're flatter and make the whole car look lower and wider. Like it wasn't really wide enough already, but hey. AMG's 4-litre twin-turbo V8 is like the Swiss Army knife of engines. They've managed to cram it under the bonnet of almost every Mercedes, from the C-Class to the AMG GT sports car. It also goes into Aston Martins now, too. In the standard E63, this engine makes just 571 horsepower and 750 newton meters of torque. So that's exactly the same as in the old car then. What about the E63S? Well, that delivers 612 horsepower and 850 newton meters of torque, which, you guessed it, is also the same as in the old car. It does mean that the E63 estate is still more powerful than an Audi RS6 though. That only makes a measly 600 horsepower and a weedy 800 newton meters of torque. Nah, who am I kidding? Both cars are mega fast. The new E63 is just as quick as the old car. So that means the standard E63 estate will do 0-60 in 3.6 seconds, but the upgraded E63S estate is a smidge faster still. It'll do 0-60 in 3.5 seconds. So that means this practical, luxurious estate is faster than most sports cars. Its top speed is pretty bonkers too. Well, if you go for an S model anyway. The regular E63 estate is limited to 155 miles an hour. That means if you go for the E63S version, it'll do 0-60 in 3.4 seconds. Now that is quicker than a Porsche 911 Carrera 4S. The E63S saloon is the boss of them all though. Thanks to less drag, the saloon version has a slightly higher top speed than the estate at 186 miles an hour. A big German estate or saloon isn't everyone's idea of the perfect drift car. But the old E63S proved everyone wrong, because it came with an actual drift mode. Yep, that was before you got it on the Ford Focus RS or the new BMW M5. The new version gets the same four-matic selectable four-wheel drive system as the old car, so it'll be just as happy doing massive smoky drifts. But Mercedes has tweaked the way the centre differential sends power to the front wheels, so it'll now be able to magic up even more traction when you floor the throttle out of a corner. As you probably guessed, the new E63's cabin gets the same upgrades as the regular E-Class. But can you spot them? They're here somewhere. I promise you. You give up? Well, there's a new centre console. See? No more rotary dial controller. And the infotainment screens are now mounted behind one huge piece of glass, so there's no plastic bit in the middle. The steering wheel is new too. Now it gets the same cool dual spoke design and touch sensitive buttons as the regular E-Class. But there's some extra AMG badging and the awesome rotary driving mode switches, which are standard on the S model but optional on the normal E63. They're just like the ones you get in a Porsche, and I absolutely love them. One of the biggest changes for the new E63 is to do with its infotainment system. The new car gets Mercedes' latest MBUX operating system. This has two massive 12-inch screens that look better than ever, and the whole system is even easier to use. In fact, I reckon the simpler menus and responsive screens means that it's actually a bit better than BMW's iDrive. Also, the AMG gets unique performance data, such as gear speed indicator, warm-up, setup, G-meter, and a lap timer, so you can time a lap of your local Waitrose car park. The sat-nav is especially cool. It works just like the one in the new A-Class, and shows huge direction arrows over a live video feed from the car's bumper. So, no more excuses for getting lost. If your AMG E63 isn't fancy enough, you'll be able to pay extra for a few upgrades. First of all, there's the optional AMG Driver's Pack. This raises the standard E63's top speed to the same as the more expensive S version. If you pick this, you should probably also check out the optional carbon ceramic brakes. These are bigger and better at resisting fade at very high speed than the standard steel discs. There are also some new paint options to choose from. Two of these are just boring silvers and greys, but the car you see here comes in brilliant blue mango. That's a fancy way of saying satin blue. but it looks great. And it's the same as the paint you can get on the even faster AMG GT 4-door. And if you click on the pop-out banner in the top right-hand corner of the screen, you can see me race an AMG GT 4-door against an Audi R8, Tesla Model X, BMW M8 and a Porsche 911. Mercedes has given the new E63 the same safety upgrades as the E-Class. One of the best bits is a new cruise control system. This can accelerate, steer and brake the car on motorways and will automatically pull the car to the side to let emergency vehicles through. And it even uses sat-nav data to know when to slow down for junctions and bends. There's also something that Mercedes calls Urban Guard. Now, it sounds a bit like a deodorant, but it's more like a personal security guard for your car. The onboard cameras and sensors constantly monitor the car. They'll alert you via the Mercedes Me app if someone bumps into it or tries to break in while it's parked. There's also some extra blind spot warning features that let you know if you're about to open your door into a cyclist or a pedestrian. Mercedes hasn't revealed just how much the new E63 will cost, but you can expect it to be a bit more expensive than the old version when it goes on sale later this year. So that means you'll have to hand over at least £85,000 if you want the normal E63 saloon, and a few thousand quid more for an E63 estate. Fancy an S model? Well, they'll be getting on for £100,000, and even more for the estate. Now, if you click on the pop-out banner in the top right-hand corner of the screen, you can see how much money you can save on a new car through CarWow.